George's mom, can I ask you a question?
I think you wish to argue, sir. I don't want to argue.
I'm not arguing. I actually have
Here's
a
what
question.
your problem
Any
your
disagreement is an
problem
argument,
is.
right?
You're okay.
Look, I can easily break this whole down. They could have avoided all that unnecessary talk. Basically, what's going on is men like wealthy men like traditional women. You're not traditional, and that's it. Women don't like to talk about the things that make them look bad, such as the guy they tried to get a conversation with and he showed no interest, or the guy they gave their number to that didn't call or didn't have time to talk to her, and then the other guy that said, well, he's looking for a housewife and you're not it. Okay, wealthy men like traditional women. And women don't like to talk about the things that make them look bad, so they're not going to mention that. We like traditional women, period. They're not going to talk about the modern women that hit me up in my DMs, and I told her I was a passport bro, and I don't like American women. See, they don't talk about the things that make them look
You're a
bad. They
passport
try to
bro?
put on the persona. Yeah, I'm a passport bro. I have
But
an
you're a
Ethiopian
passport
wife.
bro?
Yeah, I'm a passport bro.
Oh my God. Oh my God. Noble, there's no way you let. Oh God. You're
I'm
a
sorry.
passport bro? You're a
In other
passport
words,
bro?
I have high standards of behavior for women, and American women simply don't cut it. Their character doesn't
Noble,
qualify.
get him before I get him, Noble. Get him
Know
before I
what?
get him.
Know what? I'm
You
gonna
have
debunk. Know
passport.
what? I'm gonna intellectually
Thank
rip you to
you.
shreds. Look, the only way you can
No,
get
you're
me
not.
is to prevent me from talking or just kick me out the box. But I will intellectually dominate you right now.
No, you're
No,
not.
Chad,
You're a
let him
passport
finish. Let him
bro.
finish.
Do
Chad,
you
let him
want to
finish.
take on a challenge?
No,
I'm gonna
hold
tell
on.
you,
Here,
I'm gonna
time out,
intellectually
time
rip
out,
you to
time out, time
shreds.
out, time out, time out, time out, time out. Charles, I'm not kicking you out the box, but listen, I have an open platform. You're able to express however it is you feel about what we're talking about here. You're all good. Chad, let him finish because we need to let Supervillain talk and we need to let
Okay.
Vada speak as well. So Charles, aside from what you were just talking about, I want you to give your honest take on, Ebony K. Williams' recent comments. And, if you want to speak on anything that you heard, excuse me, Jordan's mom and myself discussing, you can comment on that as well.
All right.
Shout out to my girl. Shout out to my
All right.
baby. Shout out to my
All
baby
right,
Bria in the building.
It's
pretty much simple. The men they want don't want them, and they don't like to admit it because they like to put on their persona that they're above men. But the truth is, the men that you want, most of them don't want you. Because I'm telling you, wealthy men like traditional women, you are not traditional, period. They try to persuade men. Well, I'm half traditional. I have a traditional. I don't want to hear that. If you're not going to be a stay-at-home housewife, kick rocks. Period. We don't have, there's women. There's 195 countries. We don't have to settle for you. Okay, you don't qualify, and that's just the bottom line. But they don't like to mention things like that, and that's just what it is. As a passport bro who had many American women. Right, and the man is going to it's like this, it's evolution. This is how it goes. May the best woman win. American women simply cannot compete because Ethiopian women and women from overseas, I personally like, I have an Ethiopian wife. Your character cannot compete. They're raised to be
And
wives.
yet here you are beating your tambourine talking about American women.
So what's wrong with that? All right, look, all right, look. I'm
No.
concerned about American society, right? And it's a fun topic. I'm telling you what the problem is. You
And
cannot
I'm
compete.
telling you that
Look,
you went
we.
you got a
Bro,
foreign
this is the
wife
thing.
because American women didn't want you. You are
No,
you lack
no, no, no,
self-esteem,
no. You know what?
you lack
Remember
a
when I.
personal awareness, and you're
That is
unlucky.
literally the whole
We don't like
passport
you.
bros dilemma.
All right, may I respond,
Literally, that's what it
please?
is.
Wait. May I respond, please? So you're telling me passport bros are all virgins? Huh?
No, she's
Okay,
saying
look,
that's
listen,
not
listen,
what
listen.
she's
So
saying.
no, listen, listen, listen,
That's
listen.
not
Your
what she's saying,
claims,
and you know it.
may I talk, please? Your claims are unverified. The truth is, passport bros It's we made a mass rejection of all American women, and it makes you look bad. So you try to change our narrative to we left because no woman wants us. You have no evidence. There's no data. Most passport bros got ex-wives. We got ex-American wives. We have kids by American women. You're lying. You listen. You are stating
Listen,
unverified
look
claims.
at you condemning
You on all
yourself.
ladies,
Ma'am,
ladies, ladies, ladies,
ma'am,
ladies,
ma'am,
ladies,
ma'am,
ladies,
ma'am,
ladies,
ma'am,
ladies,
ma'am,
ladies.
Ma'am,
Hold on,
do
Charles. Hold on,
you?
Charles. Charles, hold on, hold on, hold on. Ladies, please let him finish talking. When he is done talking, I will give y'all the opportunity to challenge things that he's saying, but just let him finish talking, please.
Okay.
Go ahead, Charles.
You do not know Passport Bros personally. You didn't go around with the camera videotaping their lives. You are making this stuff up because you are trying to control our narrative because it embarrasses you to know that many men are rejecting all American women because of your horrible morals, such as lying about us, claiming we can't get women. You just made that up. Where's the it's called an unverified claim. You are literally making it up. You pulled it out of the sky. Not only are you making it up, it's an hasty generalization. It's an appeal to composition. It is a fallacy. Even if you
Am I here
find
to
one
tell
pass
you this?
Even if you find one passport bro that somehow is still a virgin, all right, you're stating a sweeping general look. I'll be honest with you. I have a black American. I have a kid by a black American woman. I had sex with the finest black American woman, the finest ones I ever see. I got them in bed. Okay, I have a black American nanny right now that my
Oh
Ethiopian
my.
woman wants me to fire because she thinks she's trying to throw the poom-poom at me. Before I married my Ethiopian queen, I had a beautiful black American woman wanted me to give her a chance first, but I told her, nope, you're a bus driver. I want a housewife. So you have, do me a favor, stop lying. Okay, I understand that a lot of you modern women have horrible moral character, and you have no problem stating unverified claims, knowing they're unverified, but you state them anyway for the whole sake of an insult. Go ahead.
Okay,
You
one
made a
second. Hold on, hold
woman
on,
a
hold on, hold
baby
on, hold on,
mama.
Vada. Wait. Here, because I do need to let everyone speak. So, Charles, please go on mute for me. I'm gonna
Sure.
play the audio one more time, and then we're gonna go super villain, and then we're gonna go Vada, and then we're gonna go Jazz. So if y'all heard what Charles had to say, super villain is gonna speak next. If you wanna address things that people say, go get your pen and your notepad and write things down so when it's your turn to talk, you can address things that people say. But I do need to let one person speak at a time, and I need to let them speak uninterrupted. So let's just listen to the audio one more time so we can all know what is being discussed here.
So I was watching this girl's video yesterday about Ebony K. Williams and Ayanla talking about Ayanla asking Ebony, would she ever date a bus driver? Ebony proceeds to say no, unless he owns the bus. So I was watching this girl video and I like her, I like her content, but some of the things that she was saying wasn't making sense to me. And I'm the type of woman, I think for myself and I don't allow others to think for me. And I'm also the type of person, if I feel like you sound ridiculous, I will also let you know as well. Here is my take on Ebony K. Williams and the Ayanla video. Why is it that when black women start leveling up, black women start leveling up, people tell us, you can't have this, you can't have that. You need to humble yourself and get this. You need to humble yourself and get that. Why is it that when we start leveling up and we start manifesting men who are on our level, oh no, don't get him. The rich men are the ones, usually are the ones with the assholes. You need to get this person and get that person because they make this much an hour and they're gonna love you and take care of you and this and this and that. Do I think there is anything wrong with dating a bus driver? Do I think that it's anything wrong with dating somebody who work at Walmart? 9-to-5 man. No, absolutely not. There's nothing wrong with that. But let me say this real quick. We've done it already. We've done it already. We've dated the men who worked at Walmart. We've dated Kroger. We've dated drug dealers. We've dated scammers. We've dated these men. Just because he make $12, $13, $14, $15 an hour, y'all, that does not mean he's faithful. That does not mean he's loyal. The nigga that work at Walmart got more game and more hoes than a 70s pimp from the Bay. He slang so much wood up and down aisle 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6 to the point where this man is set up here and knocked Esther, the damn cheetah, off a damn hot Cheeto bag. Can we mind our business? Can we mind our business? Allow people to manifest who they want to manifest. Period. If Ebony don't want to date a damn bus driver, okay. What, she not gonna make you shit, baby? Just because she don't want to date a bus driver does not mean she looks down on bus drivers. Just because he makes $12 an hour, that does not mean he's loyal. Just because he's rich does not mean he's an asshole. Let me tell my black women something. Stick to your script. Stick to your script, sis. If you want him to be fine, chocolate, tall, dark, handsome, have this, have that, sis, that's what you want. Don't allow other people to dictate for you what you should have and what you shouldn't have. The world is yours, sis. The world is yours. Period.
Super villain. Talk to the people, bro. I'm about to get a couple bottles of water. Ladies and gentlemen, I had my Dunkin' Donuts company party this evening. I had a lot of free alcohol. So, you know, I'm on my level right now. Super villain, talk to these people, bro. How you feel about what, you know, she said in the audio?
Yeah, I gotta start by saying I'm a big fan of hypergamy for women. I wanna give that disclaimer before I start. So I have no problem with women choosing to date up or aiming to date up or anything like that. I think if I had a daughter, I would encourage her to do the same. I think the issue comes into play. There's a lot of different issues. I want to actually take it back to the interview that she had with Iyanna, the lady, I forgot her name already. Ebony, sorry. She said something that I think a lot of people are skipping, because in this conversation, I've seen a lot in the chat. Women saying, or to divest from black men, or, you know, black men aren't doing enough, and black men. Ebony specifically said she's dated all of them. When she said all the races, she feels men are failing across the board. So I have to start there, so people can understand the level set. That's part one. It's not just a black men issue, according to Ebony. Part two, Ebony, from what I understand, is an educated woman. And I believe she's a lawyer, and she's been in a lot of high class and high places in social circles. So I have to think she's been in position to be around the men of the caliber that she's wanted. Factoring that in with what she said with part one, she's dated all of them. I'm assuming it seems the common denominator would be her in these situations. Why these relationships are not working for her in her favor. Not saying that she has to date down at this point, I'm just going off what she said. So when Iyanna asked her, would she date a bus driver? I don't think it was to say that she can't have access to the men that she wants at her level, at a high level. I think she was just honestly asking what her range of men were. And she said she's not interested in the bus driver. That's perfectly fine. That's perfectly her choice. The issue comes into play later when she equates basically a bus driver with somebody that's unsuccessful or not worthy of, really, she was speaking on black women in general. They're not worthy of women across the board. Men at that level are not worthy, or not providers at that level, which I don't think is true or fair. I think, in my opinion, just from my background, I'm white collar. I don't do labor at all. I get paid with my mind. I work from home. I make six figures. And I'm not saying that to brag. I'm just saying I'm in a different world than a bus driver. Those men still deserve respect, in my opinion, because they're doing a service and it's honest living. Not saying they deserve Ebony. Just saying I think they deserve a good woman, because most people are average, men and women. At some point, men and women have to come together and say, okay, I'm average, you're average. Let's make this work. I don't think a lot of women want to come to the table and admit that they're average. Then I think that's the problem. I think most in our community at this point, nobody wants to say I'm average, especially a woman. So I say that to say, I don't think it's wrong with any woman choosing to date up if they can. I think Jordan's mom made a point about a woman that's 24, no kids and things like that, basically in her prime. If she wants to aim up and chooses to date a high earning man that can cater to her lifestyle and, you know, set her up nicely and put her away and provide a lifestyle, I have zero problem with that at all. Going back to her example, and I'm gonna end it on this, a lot of these women feel that they're jaguars and they are way past that point at this point. Right. But they will still argue and think, well, I'm educated now, I'm a good mother, I have two kids, but I'm a great mother, I'm active, I'm active in my kids' life, I do this, I have a great personality. That's great. Those men that you're looking for, that 10%, 20% of men that have the finances and have that ambition and that drive, as I said before, most people, men and women, are just not successful. Those men are very rare, and you have to figure out specifically what those men want. And if they don't want you, you can't get mad at the men that are left. You just don't qualify at that point. The same thing we would tell a man that doesn't make the money he needs and wants to date, I'll say a Beyonce, just because everybody knows a Beyonce, where a beautiful woman that's young and in her prime. We tell those men the truth, and no, society doesn't bat an eye. But if we tell older women the truth that are past their prime, we're evil and we're wrong. We're just being honest with you. Shout out to Kevin Samuels. This is his anniversary today, Noble.
Yeah.
Okay. I feel women had the best opportunity to learn game from Kevin Samuels on how to get the men that they want. And I don't think he told them to do too much as far as like get in shape and be feminine and, you know, heels, wear heels and all this stuff. I don't think it was too bad, but I thought that was the most helpful advice that any man could have given a woman if she wanted that caliber of men. So, and they demonized him for it, and they literally spit on his grave, or figuratively spit on his grave. So I don't know what women are trying to do at this point to get those men, or if they want to, because most, from what I hear in these conversations, seem to be proud, saying, "I bring me to the table, I am the table."
Right.
That's not going to
cut. Nah, I don't know why women think it cuts it. I am the table is the funniest one.
It's like I don't know why y'all think y'all gonna get these very few 10-20% of men with that mindset. Good luck to you. But yeah,
That's why I always tell them. Like, you know, they get on these different platforms and say the things that they say, but they only sound, I don't even want to say smart, because they definitely don't sound smart. They only sound like they're saying something to someone that's dumb. And someone that's just completely uninformed, someone that's just completely ignorant. Like I was telling Jordan's mom, like you just said, as a man or a woman, you can trick yourself to believe that you're someone you're not. You can trick yourself to believe that you're doing things in society, in your real life, that you're not. But at the end of the day, everyone is getting what they deserve. You're getting what you deserve, okay, black woman? So when you say you are what you attract, you are what you attract. The reason that you're attracting, and I'm using the words that y'all use, the reason that you're attracting pookies and ray rays and dusty, broke, low quality, low vibrational, ain't shit men is because you're a dusty, low quality, low vibrational, ain't shit woman. You are a low quality, low vibrational, ain't shit bitch. You are a dusty, broke bitch. And that's why you are, that's talk why that you are shit, attracting. Man. That's why you are attracting those caliber of men. I don't care how y'all feel about it. At the end of the day, it is what it is, okay? We're not gonna acknowledge it one way and then completely decide to like not acknowledge it another way, okay? It is what it is. If you want to change those circumstances, you're gonna go to the drawing board and you're gonna put in the necessary work to change those circumstances. If not, you're going to continue to get the results that you've been getting in life. Okay? That just is what it is. You completely understand it when it's a man, but when it comes to y'all, you just don't understand it. It just don't register for some reason. But listen, I'm gonna make sure, if nobody's gonna tell you this, I'm going to tell you this, and you do what you want to do with it, okay? Because at the end of the day, Any, this goes for the men too. Anyone that wants to change their circumstances, you're going to need to put in the work to change those circumstances. If you don't want to put in the work, you are going to continue to get the same results. Insanity is doing the same thing and getting a different result every single time. The same way in life that for a job may have certain qualifications for you to even apply and get an interview. That's the same thing for dating. The reason that a lot of y'all get used and abused, the reason that a lot of y'all get y'all tracheas abused and get sent.
Oh my God, yo.
Is because the men that you're dealing with don't have any standards for you. I try to tell y'all all the time, the men that don't have any standards for you don't care about you. The woman that a man wants to make his girlfriend, the woman that a man wants to eventually make his wife, the woman that a man is vetting to see if he could see this woman being a great mother of his kids one day, he is going to care about all of those things. And men come to a point in time in their life where they're going to care about those things. For some men, it's earlier. For some men, it's later. But those things are going to eventually matter. So just like, you know, and you don't have to listen to what I'm saying. I don't get on here to give y'all advice. I don't get on here to preach to y'all. I'm not a coach to anybody. But I just want to say that. Go ahead and say whatever else you want to say, Supervillain. Thank you, Bree, for the gifts, by the way. I appreciate it. Go ahead, Supervillain.
Yeah, I wanted to say, well, maybe you guys two more things and I'm done. So just looking at the comment, like a lot of these women are talking about like the degrees, and it's like, I go back to saying this earlier, men that y'all want, the 10-20% of men that y'all want to put y'all away and live nice and pretty, they do not care about y'all degrees. I don't know. Men have said this for so long, and it's like, I don't know why it doesn't register. You've had broke men say this, average men say this, and rich, well-off men saying this. Men across the board do not care about your degrees. It's not a factor for us dating you. And I say us, I mean six figures up. I'm like, if that's your range, they don't care about the degrees. And at the end, it's just going to be more debt for you. There's nothing wrong with I think it's okay to be self-sustaining. Don't get me wrong. I'm not saying don't get a degree if it's going to be, you know, be sufficient for you to sustain yourself. That's fine. But if you're trying to date a man that's in the top 20%, 10 or 20%, please don't think your degree is helping you in that process of dating and vetting. It's not. Second thing, I think we were equating to Jaguars.
Mm-hmm.
This is the last thing I'm gonna say. You can be a Jaguar. However, Jaguars have a certain amount of people, a certain level of people that are able to drive them off the lot, brand new. If you are a woman that is easily accessible to those of lower class men with a bad credit score and they don't have a job and they Madden Masters and PlayStation vets and Call of Duty vets, and you're having relations with these men and you're having children even worse with these men, you've basically just disqualified yourself as that Jaguar. Men that value who they have things to lose and are going to make a heavy investment in you, and they see you dealing with these kind of men, they are going to stay far away from you, or they're going to use you just for complete strict recreational purposes. And I'm only saying that just to help you out in your journey. Because I say this because a lot of women say, until I meet that guy, I'm going to just deal with this pookie or this dude over here because he provides some entertainment and the sex is good. Until that one comes along, I'm just going to keep dealing with these low caliber men in the meantime, and think that we're okay, like high class or high earning men are okay with that. They're not. It's going to hurt you more than anything. And again, you also increase your chances of having a child with them, or worse, STDs. Like, it's just it's no point in dealing with those men if you want to hold yourself to a Jaguar standards, because Jaguars don't drive off the lot for people who can't afford them outright. So that's my last part.
Yeah, and I wanted to say something real, because that's another thing. You know, Jordan's mom, I don't know if you're still here. I wanted to say that to you, you know, when you were talking about, well, is it okay for the woman to at least, you know, believe she's the Jaguar and, you know, see if she can get those results? Ma'am, anyone can't just go to a car dealership and test drive any car. You need to qualify to be able to test drive a car as well. You're not about to just go, anyone can't just go test drive a Rolls Royce Anyone can't just go test drive a Ferrari or a Lamborghini or a damn, I don't know, Hellcat. You need to, like, it's qualifications at the end of the day. It's like I said, y'all can sit here and think that you don't need to qualify, but you're just going to continue to not get those results that you say that you want.
Hold on, real quick, because people are saying, yes, you, let me give them another analogy. Let's just say for the sake of conversation, a test drive.
You said one more thing.
Yeah, I'm going to say one more thing. You're gonna wait. So a test drive is like a 15, 20-minute engagement. That could be a coffee date. When y'all saying test drive, y'all talking about y'all having sex with these men. Y'all letting the men just take y'all and lease y'all.
Riding that carousel.
So it's like, if you're going to equate yourself to a Jaguar that's getting test driven, don't let it be the carousel. If you want to say you're going out with men on dates and just getting to know them, perfectly fine, perfectly acceptable. But again, that's just if you want to equate yourself to that prestigious Jaguar. That's all I'm saying.
Supervillain, ladies and gentlemen.